have you ever felt?
Are you listening? Damn.
Welcome back, everybody. Shinoska, Farming Simulator 17 here at Mr. Blue Farms. Folks, let's see. Gotta go start my little robot. We got the combines parked away. I done a reset on them. Alright, this is the guy we need to start right here. Get our little icon up here. Kind of hard getting him straight. The ground's so uneven right there. But he does pretty good. I did do some fast forwarding since the last episode. Everything we got is fertilized. First thing we're going to get into, folks, at the mill. Okay, see, the mill is 934 for soybeans. Okay. So y'all see how bumpy that was right there. I don't know if y'all saw that or not. Watch this right here. You should hit it. Yeah, see how it goes up like it, that throws them off track after so long. Folks, let's see. Right down here, we got moving some stuff around. I got plowed out some, as you can see. All that is ready to be planted, set for it, stripped next to the beans. And I didn't want to do that. These tractors are back to back now, as you can tell. I got this out here, the wagon for the new combine. I turned back in. Okay, folks, we got this in here. Maybe we can use it. Where is, what am I looking for? Okay. I'm loaded, fixing to go to the mill. As you can tell right there, I got one more load of chaff on there, but that was it. I didn't tarp it yet. There is a reason behind that. Yeah, sorry, mister. That's for not waiting on me the episode when I was trying to look sexy in the truck there. Alright, we're going to get our beacons on, get some lights on. And to the mill we go. We going to go. How y'all doing, folks? Y'all been doing all right? Hope y'all enjoyed the last couple episodes. Been trying to change it up a little bit. Instead of just harvesting all the time or planting all the time, trying to do some in-between jobs here. Kind of spruce things up a little bit. Let's see, we got some soybeans we're going to haul. We're going to haul this load to the mill. We're going to haul to the mill till they drop the price where it's unreasonable. And then we're going to go to the other place. Oh, there, I was going to show you a big old pile of heaping wood chips there. Yeah. I'm going to go this way this time. I knew that car was going to go that way, so that's why I did that. Let's see, let's go this way. That way be right with the switch and getting out and everything. Ooh. Oh, I wish I could get it, folks. There's something about getting on top of the tallest thing. Makes me rise up so... Well, yeah. PG-13, Mr. Blue. PG-13. Ah, we're at the mill, and the mill price is $9.34. Let's see. Mill $9.34, and transport company is $8.23, which is going up. So, might have to fast forward time a little bit here. Let's see, what was I doing? Oh yeah, that button. I wish I was on top of that building too. Maybe it's not the buildings I want on top of. Maybe I want this to be on top always. Oh, think about that. I like big trailers and I cannot lie. Oh, Lord. Please, Mr. Boo, don't start that. Not so early in the episode. We like your videos, but we don't like you singing. Can't touch this. Dang, 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 dang. Dang, dang. Oh, speaking of can't touch this, folks, last episode, I think it was, wherever I used the, I think it was I Can't Touch This and some other song, I got scared. Remember I said I hope they don't get me for copyright? Well, that episode I got unknown error from YouTube when I was doing my upload. Alright, we're sending the train off. Folks, give me just a second. I'm playing without my earphones. Shame on me. I can't hear that with them off. And if I turn the volume up on the TV, we get a bad echo, and we don't want an echo in our video. Alright, Dirt Slur Series 9. Let's get boogieing, shall we? Before we go too far, meal down to 804. Ooh. Ooh, 804. I should have checked before I sent that off. I don't know, the prices dropped before or after that switch is pulled. I guess we won't find out till next time, huh? Anyway, folks, right here at this silo bunker, all the trees been got on that side. All the roots been got, or stumps, I should say. All we have is one big heaping pile. No, I had that set up. Oh, but since we got a little bit of time left, we're gonna fill our trailers up, folks. Yes, we're gonna fill trailers up with wood chips. Get this pile off the ground. Oh, hey, it's working! Yay! Wow, I'm in the wrong one. My bad. Let's go move the other one. Thought I was in the little one. I'm just curious to see how many wood chips we got on the ground. It's one reason why we're doing this. I know Jim Bob and Billy Bob over here with some shovels of rakes, raking this crap off the ground. Alright, this may take a little bit. Yeah, we're on into 10,000, so after we get this trailer here filled up, we're going to go see what else we got. I think we're pretty much caught up. But I want to do a couple of missions in this episode, so as you know, whoa. Alright, we had 65 to 70,000, and that load brought us up to 150,000. Now that's what I'm talking about. Anyway, while we're waiting, let's go ahead and throw that in the bank. Call up my broker here.
Yes, I want to deposit some money today. Oh, yeah, about $150,000, please.
All right, folks, $50,000 left and our loan will be paid off. Maybe we need to go sell these wood chips. Let me get pulled up here, waiting on this. All right, it's $21,000 right there. Still got a pretty good pile left to go, folks. Wood chips, yeah, that's what we're going to do. Price the wood chips. These buttons are so loud. No, folks, we ain't going to sell the wood chips today. No, sirree. I'm glad that did that. That was an email. WREG newsletter. I'm going to put my phone on vibrate and put it way over out of the way. Because, folks, I want to apologize. Last episode, I heard a little in it, and that's not right. Now, we're just going to bob around here. Yeah, see, I got the mower over there. I didn't wash it. I plan on using it some more. So, yeah, we're pretty much squared away. Just got to do these odd jobs here. I just hope it reaches. As long as it's still rolling in, I ain't going to bother about anything on it. Yeah, folks, we got to get a tractor replaced. Not that, and that's the case. It's the Zetra Vertera, or whatever how you pronounce it. Alright, that's two trailers. Oh, it would. Go ahead and tarp that in a while there. Alright, reline our conveyor. Let's see, is that hooked up? No, good. Getting it this one. And we're just going to pull it on up to about right there. Hop out. Don't never put it in the pile. Well, you can put it in the pile too much, but if you put it too far, it might just fall down, and then it's not going to work. No, it won't work that way. Dang. I would connect these two. Oh. Back up there. There, you attach to it. Then you might have problems. But, you know, this thing here stands out, so it shouldn't be too much of a problem. If I was going to put this on the pile, I'd put it about right here. If you put it too far in there, it's going to leave something behind it. So that's why I always do that right there. As you can tell, it comes on over here. See, that's going down. It might leave a little bit around, but you can just detach, scoop it up. Oh, yeah. Missions. I was in the right one. Listen here. I've been doing these missions over here, folks. I think it's field 16. Let's visit him real quick. He's wanting us to do some planting. But it's about 10 minutes. We got him down as low as we can go, folks. He won't go no lower. See, that's field 16. Let's go, trying to find this other field real quick. Alright, folks, this shouldn't take too long. 13. See if we can get one a little bit better. 17. Alright. Can't beat this, folks. I like a lot of that spray right there. That sucker covers some ground, folks. Let me tell you. It only goes like 7, I think. But check out this massive, massive spread. Oh, I'm returning. I'm just backing up. Got wide. Almost as wide as that big guy. Of course, that's one I like to have. All right, here we go, folks. Check this out, check it out, check it out. What do you think about it, huh? You can put it lower to the ground and raise it up higher. But y'all probably already know this. You can turn off the sprayer. See this side, this is lights and stuff. Turn our beacons and but check that out, old folks. It's got lights. I don't know if you can see them. They'll turn off. And turn on its lights on the sprayer. That's pretty neat. So they'll get in here. Got some there you can probably see. Yeah. Fine, it's good. But yeah, I thought about buying one of these, you know, when I get on up there and get millionaires. That'll help in that big field. You know, he's only 7 mile iron, but we're just going to have to check it and see how he does when he's hired to work. I think he can hire to work. Should be able to. If not, you know, ain't nothing but a thing. They're going to hire us to do a little bit around the farm, help save some money, you know. That's why I like doing these missions by myself. You know, save some money. I wish you could hire a worker to do it. Folks, let's see. Let's see if I can get this right. It's supposed to be like right there in real life. Yeah, right there. And see how wide the tires are? That's why you don't need wide tires. You destroy some of your crops. But it's supposed to be two rows and between the tires. That's how you count your rows. You don't never count the rows in the middle. If you're turning towards your left, you want to count. See, I want to stop here. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 14, 15, 16. Oh, crap. I lost count at 17. 17 rows on the left or right wingspan. Thank you there. I appreciate it. All right. As you can see, it dropped the price on this one because we still ain't got that green bar across there. Let's get back to our tractor here. And he's not full all the way. Dead coming. Okay, I loaded some. You don't want to turn too sharp because you do make everything haywire too. See? But it does straighten up, it just takes a little bit. And the only thing I'm doing is driving across here. We'll make sure we get all the wood chips up, folks. We don't want no glitches from it. Which it might not work, you know, be glitches on this one. But yeah. Why? Alright, we're going to get these guys ready for transport. Have that all the way in. Switch to the hood. You can switch it to the hood, but fold belt, it works on the big one. Why is the change angle? It's just not working on that. We need that tongue down. But I never figured out how to transport both of these together. So, farmers, Xbox One peoples, please leave a comment down below so I know how or if. Might not be able to. Alright, folks, let's see. All the wood chips are up now. Not bad. Almost three trailers worth of wood chips. Man. I know they're low. That's pretty much like giving them away. But it is right there, and that would be a little bit money now. Wouldn't have to worry about putting them in storage and undoing them later. So let's go ahead and go over here to biogas real quick and sell these. That way we get started loading some more beans up and hauling them off, okay? Okay. Folks, Christmas time is coming up early and fast. Well, not early, but you know what I mean. It's right around the corner. That's what I was going to say. I don't know why that second trailer always wants to go down first. Let's see what kind of deal we're making here. Let's see, get it where I can see it. $4,031 a trailer. I just unhooked the trailer. That's not bad, folks. You can see it better right there, can't you? Not bad. 4,000 something. Let's see if this is going to be the same. 3,892. They dropped the price on us. Because those two trailers were full. This was a piece of one. So 150,000 plus. Come on. Oh, it could have put us over 15 just a tiny bit. Dang it. 14,587. That ain't bad, though. Not what little work we done. And we do have the logs there, too, folks. We need to sell them. And let's see, I need to sell them because we need that trailer to haul some different logs a different way. I'm not going to show y'all that way, but yeah. No, it's all right. And plus, also, I don't know if y'all know, but all the trees around here are gone now, except for up there. Yes, folks. Yes. Moving on along. But we need to get those other ones across there done. We got to get some of these cut too. Ones closer to the road. And not mention over there by the pond on the other side. Get 2015 there. Alright, before I load these up, I'm going to look at the map one more time. Whoa. And to see what damages we can do. Transport company is going up, folks. Okay. Everything I got is done. You know what I mean. You know, cows 100% and everything. It's time to fast forward. Let's do the max, folks. I don't know why I keep cooking off. And show y'all this. See, all our fertilization's done. Our growth is fixing to turn to the ready state somewhat, but we're going to wait till everything gets to the orange, folks. I think we get more for it. As you can see on your top right of the map, those are the, well, kind of yellowish orange. It's the middle color there. So, yeah, we're going to wait till it gets to orange. I know people start cutting as soon as it gets to yellow, but I'm just, oh, there I go again, clicking off. I'm supposed to click over. 940, folks. Please reach 1,000. We want to get 1,000. Oh, we got left. 58,000. We can haul all that one time, folks. Almost there. 10 away. We might be selling some barley too. Oh. Oh, folks. Oh. Fix to have a heart attack. It's over 1,000 now. That's going to help us a lot, folks. It's going to help us a lot. Oh, it's slowing down. Slowing down. I'm going to squeeze it. I'm going to squeeze that lemon. I'm going to squeeze that lemon to its lemon squeezy. Oh, God, that didn't make no sense, but I'm sorry, folks. Come on, we're going to squeeze it to the arrow or the price quits rising. Whichever one it comes first. Be nice when we get up there to 1,100. Folks, I just saw our crops turn. Alright, 1053. Guess, whoa, oh no, wrong button. Gotta turn the time down. Okay. Ah. Yeah. Let me load. I want to hit that load button there. Oh, is that 5,000? No, that's going on past. Okay, good. Get back over here. Oh, yeah, it's 40-something thousand. Good. $1,053, folks, at the transport company. Oh, my God. Wait. Village grain elevator is 436 for... No, that's wheat. That's 377 back. We're going to go ahead and load up the barley, too, folks. Wrong one. Ah. Yes, beans. Oh, Jesus. Look at that, folks. I love that dashboard and computer screen. Oh, my. This thing's got so many gadgets and gadgets. It's actually turning me on. Here, I got the brand name on the seat. Blue. A little bit of every color in here. A little bitty buddy seat, though. That looked like that'd be in a way of getting out from, you know, the main driver getting out, being in a way. Should have been scooted back some. All right, folks, we got to pull up here. And they're probably like, "How do you know when to stop?" Folks, look at your little helper thing right there. Gray box in the top left. See, it says stops filling. When you can move up, and it says starts. See, it just quit. Okay. It should say start filling again. Yep, see, right there. And you just click it. No more soybeans, folks. Oh, barley and canola. Oh, not enough canola. 16 on barley. We're going to take it. We need all the money we can get. Excuse me. Time to tarp our trailers here with the automatic tarps. Okay, that's done. Where did that barley need to go? We're going to transport company of beans. Barley to which 369 Village Grain Elevator. So it's, yeah, we're not going to go all the way bakery out of the way. Village Grain Elevator is on the way. Just got to go across top of the screen. So it's somewhat on the way. But we got to make sure we dump the last trailer. Yeah, the last trailer needs to be dumped. Then the rest of it goes to transport company. Come on, baby. Yeah, folks, we're going to have to get a bigger tractor than this one here. And I had two more trailers to this. Whoa. Oh, no. Oh, yeah. There we go. Don't ride the rails, boys and girls. Don't ride the rails. Especially when you got loaded cargo behind. Alright, I'm probably asking for trouble, but I'm going to take a shortcut. Yay. Now, I'm going to go behind the building and then come up and through. See, folks, you can sell hay there, too, looks like. Bring some over here. Try it. Might be more for the dollar over here. Yeah, three trailers on, the last trailer's there, it should, yeah, good. I sure don't want to sell none of our beans here. Alright, let's get going to transport company now. Let's see here. Turn on a little mini map, see if we can find a shortcut. Let's see. I don't know about cutting through the woods. We'd have to go up that hill there. Folks, we're up right at the top center, just in case you're trying to find us. Oh, I ain't checked on the chickens in a while. I will do that later. I think we need to cut. Is it this road? No, that wasn't it. Let's go over to this other road here. Yeah, we'll do that. Cut across 18 and across. Yeah. We did it that way. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Gotcha. And we're just going to drive through this man's field here. You know, no damage done, right? Pow! 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 Dead Mr. Blue. I'm just kidding, folks. And we should cut through this right here and come out right at the transport company. Oh my god. More trees to clear. Folks, we ever get these fields here, that, and this, and we are going to clear this out and make those fields bigger. That's a lot of ground right here. They're wasted. Let's see here. Yeah, I think I'd enter it right here. Yep. Enter there. Kind of make a wide turn there. Come up straight on the dumping spot here. And voila. I can't remember if this train station gives you a bonus or not. I wish you could dump two trailers at a time. I really do. Alright, 22,117 on that. That's probably going to drop a little bit. Whoa, that's a big drop. Oh, man. That is a big drop. 6, 20, whatever it was, 16. That's how they get you, folks. That was 20. Oh, the back one wasn't full, folks. That's why. Duh. Oh, whoa, whoa. Where did that switch at? Got to pull the switch. We're going to try it this time. I'm listening. We're going to be prepared. Usually about 2 minutes. Sometimes three. There goes the train. The train's going. Want to see if we can catch a train? I'm curious where that goes. I really am, folks. There it goes. Is it showing a map? Yeah, it goes down the lumber yard and it disappears. Oh, stay on the road, Mr. Blue. Oh, this is bad. We're catching the train, folks. We are catching a train. We're going to rob the train. We're going to rob a train. We're going to be Barney and Clyde or whatever those race winners are. Uh-oh. What? I hope ain't another train coming. I hope there ain't another train coming. Oh, we're going to be... We are one with the train, folks. We are one with the train. Chicka chicka choo choo. Try to get the train to blow with us. There's our freight, folks. There's our barley and stuff. I know this end somewhere here. Oh! Wow. Now, Mike, why circle so I don't get hung on it? Oh, well, crap. Yeah, I'm all going to hit that pole if I don't keep it wide, folks. If I quit hitting the wall over here, I'll be even better. Alright, that's perfect. I didn't look at the time, what was it? 1450? No, it wasn't that. We're going to call it 1452. And if we don't hear nothing by 1455, we know we ain't going to get a bonus. Is that the train? Is he going or coming? Is he coming back already? I can't get through. Our train just went there and stopped, didn't it? Can't see over the... Can't see over the fence. Ah, come on. I want to see. Oh, no, folks. Oh, my God. He's coming back. Turn around. We got to get our trailers. We got to get our trailers off the tracks. Come on. Pull off. Come on. Pull. Oh, oh no. This, whoa. I don't think we're going to get a bonus for that, folks. Wow. Oh no. Bad idea. Bad idea. Let's just get these completely off the tracks. Oh, wow. You seen it here first, y'all. Y'all seen it here first, I hope. My son would be proud of me. Oh, my goodness. That's why you never park on a train track, folks. How am I going to get that off? Oh, okay. That's one way. Yeah, keep hopping and bobbing. Maybe. Oh. I'm going to wait, yo. Oh, no. Maybe I hit the tail end and spin it all around. Okay. No, don't go back in there. Ah. So much for farming, folks. I bet you I'm going to have to reset all these triggers. Oh, wow. Let me try one more thing, folks, real quick. I'm going to ram it so hard she's going to say, ow. Oh, wait. She won't budge. Oh, my goodness. Try it from this side. That don't work. I'm just going to have to reset them. Oh. Come on. You was moving. Come on. Maybe that's enough to get it attached. And I hate to hook all these back up. That's going to be worse than anything. It's going to be worse than train hitting us. All right. Come on. Come on. You're almost there. Come on. Let me drop my weight. That was bad. I had it almost out. Figure if I could detach and reattach real quick. No, don't get back over there. One more try. But wouldn't put me against a pole. Come on. Alright, let's go back this way, if you want to go that way. Oh, this killing time's killing me. But I didn't know their tongues could stretch that far, folks. Oh, whoa. Come on. Alright, that's it. I don't know which one you are, but folks, we got Bain's still up pretty good, transport company. We're out of them. Well, I'll play Russian roulette with these trailers because I don't know which one's which. Oh, no, it's not that, so let's see if this is it. Nah, no. If I zoom in, That should be when I reset. Alright, that's it, folks. Should I just go ahead and reset them all? That way they'll all be in one spot. Probably be easiest, wouldn't it? Down here, to the tractors. Got that and reset. Okay, we got one more, well, three more actually. Nothing's up there. All right, that's down there. Okay, it should be just the tractor and the weight left. Okay. Go to the weights. See if I get a green circle around one of them. Yes, that's it. That right there, reset. And have a quick look around just to make sure. Alright, ho ho ho. We have to put all these together, folks. Not a good thing. Alright, that's a straight one, so we're going to put this in here. In front of one of these other green ones. Because remember, this is the hard to back trailers. This is why I don't play around folks very much. Like Jacob, or Zombie Slayer does. Now he'll play all day long, reset them and stuff. This ain't for it, folks. I like racing around every once in a while and stuff with them, but when it comes to actually having to reset all this stuff, I'm just not for that. Come on, start turning. All right, that was perfect. Gotta get straightened up a little bit there. All right, look at this bad boy. I wish all of them was like this. It'd be kind of like the gray trailers then. Which I like the gray trailers because they hold more, but they don't tarp. So when it starts raining, it's just, your stuff gets wet. And you know, it's just not realistic. But folks, I do want to buy one thing. Well, got to buy a couple of things. I want a corn planter, for one. Yep, you guessed it. Right after the harvest, I want to save probably 14 and 19 for planting corn. And then we'll go and buy the two-row, yes, folks, the two-row chaffer. Yeah, another trailer. Alright, let's see here. What we got left? Well, I got 5,000 canola. I I was looking at the wrong thing, folks. I was looking at sugar beets there. Seen 139. I was thinking we had 139. I'm like, how? We don't have nothing else but a little bit of canola. I think we're going to save that for when we get pigs. Folks, I know when how can I say this? It's not, but we're going to take a little trip up here. And we're going to go to Animal Dealer. Open up a little dialogue here. We got 10 cows already. Ten sheep would be what, 40,000? See, let's buy a sheep. One sheep, two sheep, three sheep, four, five sheep, six sheep, seven sheep, more. Oh no, this kidding, folks. I did fall asleep. Eight sheep? No, we need 10 sheep, don't we? Ten sheep and it's going to cost $2,000 for them to deliver. That's a long ways down there, folks, so it's worth that $2,000. We just bought us 10 sheep. Yay! Wait. Sheep? 10? Okay. Just making sure. Alright, we got 10 sheep. Our fields are about ready to harvest, so I'm going to leave these tractors on. I'm just going to park them right here. We're going to go ahead and get our combines out, get them ready. Don't think it's supposed to rain anytime soon. All right. Now I'll go around the tree. She'll be coming around the mountain when she comes. Oh yeah, she'll be coming around the mountain when she comes. Yeah, that's what she said. What? Oh, he's still doing good at that. Let's check our fields. Canola, 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 canola. Bing, bing, beans. Okay, growth, that's what I want to see. Now, we still got a ways to go. We want it orange. Now, we want it to be orange, folks. Then we got to take the sheep some water. Oh my God, we got to take sheep some water. Let's see here. We got to get the sheep some water. Water. Are they going to be thirsty? Seen it here first, folks. Wee-haw! Okay. I'm done. It's all out of my system now. Yeah. Yeah, we're gonna finish dumping in some here. Alright. Tearing the crops up? Shame on me. All right, folks, we are not going to get water but nowhere but the river. It's free there. I still got a compactor. That's why I'm driving through it every now and then. And you're like, why didn't you cross the bridge? Well, I didn't want to cross the bridge. I wanted to come this way. And I want to zigzag over here. Then I'm going to follow this road. Then we're going to go through the woods to Grandma's house. Woohoo! Folks, we got about 5 minutes left, so we're going to spend the rest of it getting water. See? You can go right here. Refill, baby. Refill. Look at the money. No money's been tucking out. Totally free water. Alright. Just don't drive too deeply in it, or you will be, how can you say, up creek without a paddle? Yep. And I know y'all probably saying, yeah, 5 minutes left. What? Actually, we got like less than 4 minutes now. I know, folks. I know. Y'all wanted a 2-3, maybe 4 hour episode, but I can't do it. I just can't do it. It's too long. And it's too stressful. Last time it took almost a whole, it probably took like 20 hours to render off of the Elgato. Yes, folks, 20 hours just off the Elgato to process a 4 hour video. 4.5 hour, I think. No, it was under 4, wasn't it? Yeah, 4 hour video. No, look at our sheep, folks, look at our sheep. Watch them come running over here when I bring them water. Here's some water. Slurpy, slurpy. Oh, what, really? That's it. Dang. Folks, I think I'm going to go ahead and leave this trailer down here. Oh, we're going to have to get us a shed put somewhere. Put the water trailer. We're going to get a pallet fork and something to use the pallet fork and a trailer. Ooh. A lot of stuff going to get here pretty soon. Wow. What the? Really? You put a freaking pothole? Nah, that ain't a pothole. That's Grand Canyon right there. Somebody going to hurt their vehicle. I hurt my tractor. I'm suing Sonoka. I swear. They could have busted the front end out or something. Ooh. Maybe I get a free tractor. Yeah. Sorry, Farmer John. Had to scoot over. But, let's see here. I guess I'm going to start out by saying I'm glad y'all come out to see me again today. It was December the 9th, Friday. Yeah, you know, y'all expecting an hour and a half to up to a 4 hour video, but just can't do it, folks. Just can't do it. Stayed up too late past couple nights for one. And I got a bunch of stuff I gotta do during the day. I get off here and go to town with my mom. Get a few more things and do a couple errands, pay a couple bills. So yeah, so I'm not gonna have time really. I'm gonna get off here. I should have a little bit of time to get this edited. And then, after I get it edited, I'm going to go ahead and render it. That way I'll be rendering while I'm gone. Come back and try to get it uploaded before the kids get home.
Yeah, probably. Well, how are you getting this out Friday if you're... Actually, folks, for me, it's Thursday evening, okay? Well, Thursday midday. Recording this, but y'all will be seeing it on Friday. And it'll be out at 11 o'clock Friday. So that's why I'm kind of saying it like that, because less confusion. You know, if I just put the date it's going to be out on and stuff like that, it'd be better on y'all. Won't be no confusion on everybody. So, yeah. Let's do a circle around. Make sure we got everything. We got fuel. Good fuel. Good fuel. Ready to harvest. Working his little booty off cleaning. Sitting, waiting patiently for some more trees. Got fuel in him. Let's look here. Yeah, we're going to keep this case for a while, so that's why he got fuel. Oh, man, really? Okay, and the next one is these two. Got plenty of fuel. 24.4 hours, so we're going to keep him for at least another 6, maybe 11 hours, somewhere in there. This guy's got 16, so he's going to be staying for a while. Which one is that? Yeah, the little green cabbage patch. This dude here is probably going to be going here pretty soon after this harvest. Maybe. May keep him... We're not going to go over 40 hours, put it that way. Alright, there is one thing I want to do. We got just a few minutes left. Let's go to our shop menu. Before we call them up, we want to look at the planters. See, not to plant corn, but that's too small. Potatoes, that can plant corn, but that's too small. That's one we got. It'll be probably going to be getting an upgrade to that soon. Potatoes, that can plant corn, sugar beets. So that's probably one we'll get. Just need something small. We'll go in our bank account and get some more money out. Now, I don't know. We probably won't buy him this episode. We'll probably wait till the next episode. Get some thrashing done. That way I get a chance to do a couple of missions off screen. That way we won't have to pull back out of the account. Yeah. And see, we got this guy here. He doesn't fertilize. Okay. Our corn planter fertilizes and seeds. So, 2-in-1. This guy's 2. Yeah, see, that's just 1. It just plants. Plant and fertilizes on the corn. And this guy here is the upgrade to the Raptor. Ponto, it's a horse instead of Vetterstead, and it's what, 96,000. So we're going to update that planter or planter we got now to this one, and then probably buy that in there. So this one plants everything and it fertilizes, so that'll take one of the things off of the weeder. It'll be less we have to do with the weeders. You know, if Boo's planting, she can be fertilizing at the same time with this one. So it'd be a little bit better deal. Then again, we should use that. You know, it's, what I say, yeah, 61 is what, 42? Wait a second, that ain't right. 61 and 61. 1 and 1 is 2. 6 and 6 is 12. So 122. Is that right? Yeah, let's see here. 61 be 2 and 12. So 120.
Okay. That's the same price as buying two of them, so. 9 meter, 6 meter. We'll be getting three more. So, folks, might as well save up the money and just buy that. You know, why buy this one and then have to turn around and turn it back in? Want to buy this one and be done with it. And that's the biggest corn planter there is anyway, so. We can just buy it and be done. Bada bang, bada boom, you know? A little bit of something, a whole lot of nothing. Well, we can't do it right now. Well, we can, but ain't no sense in it, because midnight be coming pretty soon. We need to take this money we got here and go ahead and put it in the bank. Go ahead and pay the bank back. All right, we got $15,000. Folks, that's probably two harvest missions right there, depending on the size of the field. Now, we do have a lot of fields that's needing harvesting. Well, I'll take it back. Two fields that needs harvesting. So I'll probably do them off screen. Let's go over here and just look anyway. See what price we get. See, it's 9,000 there. 99. It's a 99, babe. Ooh, pretty baby there. All right, there's a 99. So, yeah. I'm going to go ahead and get started. Well, folks, I'm going to get started on this, but I'm going to do it off screen. Because I'm right at the hour mark, and my mom should be back here in a minute. I know. Why can't we stay till you get done? You got to get done anyway. Y'all are so hard on me, but I love y'all. But now while I'm doing this, I can be get me a drink of water because my throat's getting dry. I'll be going over my files here while I'm cutting because I might get a little crooked. I don't want to do that in front of y'all. Make y'all think I'm a bad driver or a drunk driver. Now I need to take some measures and stuff on my phone. So yeah. Hey, at least I'm giving you about 8, 9, 10 minutes over. But, like I said, folks, I thank y'all for coming out, being with me today. Thank y'all for subscribing, for hitting that like button, for the ones that does hit it. Thank y'all very much. I just want to thank y'all for being so generous to me, supporting me. Yeah, I don't know if she's going to do it or not, or playing around with me or not, but I might have to give her a dollar back, but I guess I might have to get Boo to do it. But what it is, at the beginning of every video, there's a fan funding button. You click on it, it'll redirect you to like a PayPal or something, or some kind of thing. And it says $1, $5, and other, or something like that. But I need one or two people to donate me $1 so I can see this thing working or not. And plus, this is what I'm going to do. If you donate me $1, I'll say your name, you know, give a shout out to you. But if you give me $10 or more, now make sure you put it in the comments now. But put your name in the comments so I know you donated. Just in case, you know, I don't get it right away, I'll get the comment for sure. And plus, I don't check my credit card every day anyway. But $10 or more donations will get you a name, you know, like I do with Jason and Boo and Sarah and all them. Have them drive a certain piece of equipment. If you donate $10 or more, leave a comment with your name and what you want to drive. Say you want to be a combine driver on here for a day. Okay? Just donate $10 or more and leave a comment of what you want to drive. And I'll get your name on here. Okay? That's how we're going to do that. So that will help support my channel and stuff. I'm going to be needing another Elgato game catcher. I got the Elgato HD60. I need to go with the Elgato HD60S. Difference between the two is the HD60 is, you know, regular USB plug-in on it. The HD60S is a USB, but it's the 3.0. It transfers data a lot faster than the other one. So if I can get up to, I think it's like between $160 to $180, depending on what store you're at. If I get enough donations, I'm going to buy that HD60S and then turn around and give the other one I got to my son so he can start making his own movies, videos, whatever, like Call of Duty, Infinite Warfare, that racing game he's got, what is it, The Crew, Rainbow Six. He's wanting to do stuff like that, so yeah. But that equipment's high, folks. You know, it's $150 this for that. My virus protection on this computer is going to be out pretty soon. So that's $40 right there for a year membership. My TubeBuddy membership is going to be out here pretty soon. And that's $6-$7 right there. So, you know, I don't want you to think I'm begging for money. I'm not begging for money. I just want you to know that if I can get a lot of people to start donating to my channel, that I can improve my channel faster. I'm still going to buy this stuff regardless if people donate or not. It is, you know, Christmas is here, so this month is shot. I won't be able to do nothing for this month because I'm saving for Christmas. But after that, I'm going to start doing a little side jobs and stuff. What I can, because, you know, and I told y'all my back's bad. Got back trouble, so I can't work. I ain't got approved for disability yet, so side jobs is all I got. Yeah. I can still work some, which I do side jobs now. I do paperwork for folks and stuff like that. Get paid. So, yeah. It works. You know, it's not a set job. You know, you might be sometimes, you know, this week here, you might not get it. And then next week, you might get $300-$400. You don't know. That's what I'm saying. It's not set in stone like a regular job. But it does pay the bills, keeps food on the table for my kids. And, yeah. Some money left I put back for Mad Money. And after I get so much Mad Money built up, I'll usually put like a different account. Well, it's not an account. It's just different shoebox, I should say. And, you know, that way I have my Mad Money in case something happens. You know, like hot water heater goes out, or kid accidentally busts a window out, or something goes wrong in my truck, I use that mad money for that. So I'll put back, you know, a certain amount. I ain't going to say how much, but for example, say $200 back in mad money. And then anything over that goes into the other shoebox for updating the YouTube channel. You don't never, ever, ever, folks, spend all your money. You don't do that. Don't spend all your money. It's not worth it. Always keep your nest egg back. A lot of folks think I'm flat busted broke. Well, I am broke. Because I ain't going to tell nobody about my mad money. I ain't going to tell them how much I got in there. You know, tell folks how much money you got. Oh, let me borrow $5. Or this and that. You know, which I don't mind letting people borrow stuff, you know, if they need it. If they need it, like they need some bread or something, or maybe a gallon of milk for the kids. You know, stuff like that, I don't mind loaning people money. But the other stuff, what ticks me off. I need to borrow $5. And then they go buy whatever it's called, a pint or fill for vodka and stuff like that. No, I don't do that. I need to borrow $3 or $4, man. Let me have a dollar or two. And then you see them going down the street and getting a dime bag or something. No, that's not a need. No, I don't do stuff like that. Now, if I find out that person does something like that, he ain't borrowing no more money. And the other pet peeve I got, lending folks money, you know, it's not no big deal. Until that person don't want to pay back. Oh, I'll pay you back next week when I get my check. 5 weeks later, hey man, where's my money at? Oh, didn't I pay you back? I said, no, you might have paid somebody else back, but you didn't pay me back. Mr. Blue, don't work that way, man. Where's my money at, man? I'll give it to you next week. Oh, okay. Okay. Next week come. Oh, man. I forgot, man. I forgot. I see how you are. Hey, man. Let me borrow $5, man. Man? What are you talking about, man? You didn't pay me back the first $5. Go somewhere else, man. Yeah. Sorry about that, folks. I don't know what brought that out of me. I guess that's one way y'all can get a little bit longer videos. Me go ranting and raving over money. But now that ticks me off in a way when people does that. What really gets the story is when you, but I got a bad habit. Back when I was working, I'd lend money out. I'd keep track, you know, write it down. You know, let's see, John Doe over there owes me $10 and Billy Bob over there owes me $25. Well, they don't pay and say they're going to pay the next week, Friday next week. I done had trouble with this guy before. You know, he borrowed money like 5 or 6 times. And every time I have to basically beg for the money, I used to do that. Now, not no more. John Doe over there owes me $10. Okay. Been 3 times trying to get the money back. Ain't done it yet. Ooh, he pulls up to a store. Leaves his truck unlocked. Ooh. No, I don't steal nothing out of his truck. I don't take nothing out of his truck. Well, I'll be in that truck waiting. Especially when he's got like 2 or 3 20s right down in their console there. And he owes me 10. Yeah, I'm gonna sit in that truck there and I ain't getting out. Not until he gives me a 10 out of that 20. I do that a lot. But anyway, folks, back to farming. You know, Mr. Blue don't give out money unless he really has to. Like I said, if it's for food for children and stuff, I'm all heart. And we are a little bit over halfway. But folks, we gotta go. I gotta get this process and stuff before tomorrow, I will see you. Uh-oh, it's Friday, I won't see you tomorrow. No, Saturday and Sunday is day off from Sunoco, folks. Y'all know that. We will see you back Monday, though. Will we thrash our own fields, plant some corn, update the planter, other planter, stuff like that. Maybe I'll get enough money out doing a couple missions where we can update the planter we got and buy the corn planter. And, yeah. Just enjoy the company with each other on Monday. I know, I hate Mondays. But Mondays are beautiful when I got y'all. Because I love y'all. Y'all watch my videos. Y'all support me. Yeah. Good old friends. Hanging out together. Alright, folks. As you know, Farming Simulator 17. Here at Sunoco. This is Mr. Blue. Saying, make sure you hit that like button before you go. Share me. Subscribe if you ain't done it already. Get your friends to subscribe to me. And always remember, the fan funding button is at 3 minutes and 46 seconds of the beginning of each video. Just in case y'all do want to donate. I guess that's it, folks. And y'all have a good weekend. May it be a blessed weekend for y'all. And we'll see y'all Monday. All right? Bye.